this is Bob Cannon, your township supervisor, and we have a very special treat today. Dave, who is now the vice president of CJ Barrymore's, is going to tell us why we're here and what excitement it's going to bring to not only Clinton Township, but all of Macomb County, and probably even beyond our borders. Dave, tell us about your new attraction.
Thank you. The Indy SkyTrack is something that's been in the works for many years. We actually had blueprints for it in 2019, and due to COVID, we had to kind of shelve that. But we're very, very excited. This is our 50th year, and we're very excited to bring the Indy SkyTrack in our 50th year. So it's super exciting.
It's very exciting. People all throughout the area are excited about it. You've had so much publicity free because people are excited about coming onto this track. And you see some pictures behind us, and it is quite the attraction. We can't actually go on the carts today because it's raining right now, but we will be outside so everyone can see exactly how big it is and how exciting it will be for them to come at another time. But Dave, you have been here how many years?
I've been here 36 years.
I remember when you started.
Yes.
Way back.
As a barback.
Yeah.
Yes.
You did, and Rick Iceberg has been a great employer for the community, and obviously you think that because you've been here with him 36 years. He has been here 50 years.
Yes.
He started, this wasn't like Barrymore's when it started. It was some kind of a golf thing, and it was basically you hit golf balls out. Sometimes you had to go pick your own balls up because there weren't enough workers here at the time.
It was a driving range in a cornfield.
In a cornfield.
Yeah.
Back when Hall Road was a two-lane road, and basically, the only businesses besides the golf dome were Christmas tree sales.
Correct.
And maybe one gas station.
Yes, yes.
But things have changed along Hall Road for a long time now. Is there anything you'd like the people to know that's different this year about CJ Barrymore's over what it's been the last couple of years?
Well, aside from the grand opening, we've really worked hard on training the employees to give the best customer service possible when you visit, and we're just very, very excited to share the excitement that we have being that it's our 50th year.
And I know that there's never a problem getting employees here because everybody wants to work at Barrymore's, but I know in recent years things have changed a little bit and you have allowed more people to apply for jobs. Are you still looking for people for the summer?
Oh yeah, absolutely. We're always hiring. From our winter staff to our summer staff, we add about 200 employees. So
wow.
Some will be returning from college, but we do a lot of new hires to build up for the summer. June 3rd, we go 7 days a week, and that's really where we need those employees in place to handle that 7 day a week program.
Well, you've been a great employer, especially for our younger people. And like you said, those coming home from college, most of them, you know already, are going to have a job lined up so they can bank on that. And I mean really bank on that because they need their money to go back to school with.
Correct. Yeah.
Very good. Well, thanks, Dave. It's always a pleasure to be here. It's nice to have seen someone who grew with the business to be vice president.
Yeah, I'm very proud of where I'm at today and proud of what this company is today.
You should be. We all are. Happy to have Rick Iceberg call us and tell us there's going to be a party at CJ Barrymore's because it's always a great day to come down. This probably can be called the official opening day of summer because of all the activities. And Dave, you have worked very hard over the past 36 years, working 36 of the 50 years that Barrymore's has been opened. It used to be called different names along the way, Icebergs, and there was a golf club here for a long time. But we're proud today to have CJ Barrymore's in Macomb County, and Mark Hackle and all the others who are here are very proud that this is home for a lot of entertainment and a lot of fun for a lot of people. So Dave, why don't you go ahead and take over?
I just wanted to thank the community leaders. Without their support and their guidance, it would really be hard for a business like ours to keep on investing in our business. So from Clinton Township to Macomb County to the state of Michigan, everyone that we worked with on this project in particular, I just wanted to say thank you. Clinton Township Supervisor Robert Cannon has been great to us over the years, as has Macomb County Executive Mark Hackle and Macomb County Sheriff Anthony Wickersham. So I just wanted to thank all those leaders for helping us. They make doing business in Macomb County, in Clinton Township, and the state of Michigan easy to do. Thank you.
Thanks again, everybody, for coming. We really, really do appreciate it. 50 years is a big milestone for us, and we're extremely proud of it and very proud of all the help Clinton Township has always given us. They bend over backwards to make us make it so that we can build all these weird things that we built. But the there's two real important factors that got this job done. One is the bankers. Without the bankers and the money and the proper financing, we couldn't do stuff like this. So we're happy that my longtime financial advisor, Joe Michael, he helped put together a great financing package with John McGurdy over at MSGCU Credit Union. And then Phil Cooper stepped in and put a ton of his own money into it. He's a good guy. And then we had MBC Credit Union, Bill Beardsley. Between those guys, they packaged it all up so that we could do this and grow for the future. So keeping everything in the community was a big deal with us. And then the other most important thing was the contractors on this job. Without the superstar contractors, we never could have got this built. There's no game plan anywhere in the country for building this. And to have guys like Jeff Ludwig from Northwood Contracting, me and Jeff been together 40 years, come up and say, yeah, I'll figure it out. And then Big D Construction, Daryl and Dennis Franz and Nick, for those guys to say, yeah, it's just a big giant deck. So we'll be out there putting in 5,000 boards on a deck. A1 rolled steel, he provided. Rich Florica, he's right over on the other side of Grossbeck. He provided all the steel on this job, and that was keeping that local. That was a big deal for us. And then the cement guys were phenomenal. Lee Holmes from Lee Holmes Concrete and Construction, he poured 900 yards of cement out here and stayed till 1:30 in the morning because of the cold sometimes to get the job finished. So Toit's Concrete, we've been with them over 30 years. Those guys provided all the cement. It was phenomenal, just phenomenal, the help that we had on this thing. And then Shoreview Electric, Steve Puma and Kevin Puma, thanks. Those guys, great electrical work on this thing. We got more electrical to come. And then A1 Fence, he did a heck of a job, or Royal Fence did a heck of a job. Putting in all of the stuff to make us look good. And even Lee over at Lumberjack, he provided all the boards and had them here on time. We had everything in advance. We never had a delay. And we're really proud of the contractors that we had. And if I missed somebody, I apologize. But we did have great contractors, and that's why this is so successful. The management team at Barrymore's picked up all the slack with all this stuff. Matt was happy to do 10,000 signs for this track. But it's the managers have really been the leaders on this program. They've done all the designing. We've had great engineers doing work on this. Probably the most important person is standing behind me. And he had a crew of mechanics with Dave Runyon. He had Jamie with his grounds crew. And multiple guys that are on the management team all pitched in and help build this, and that's Wayne Clore. And he's worked on this for over 2 years on the blueprints alone. And then he was here day and night. So I give all the credit to Wayne. He's built everything out here for the last 20 years. He started with me when he was 15 years old, and he's self-taught on everything out here. And he's just a wizard on the blueprints and stuff. So Wayne, step up here. Let everybody see what a star you really are.
Thanks, sir.
But I do appreciate what Wayne's done. Appreciate all your help and all of the customers, the great customers we've had over the years that are, you know, they came out as kids and then they came out with their kids and then they came out with their grandkids. So we've been lucky in 50 years to have a lot of the people just stay with us all those years. So those are all the factors that make us successful. Sorry this was so long-winded. Didn't mean to do that, Bob.
We can cut the tape.
But we appreciate it.
Don't worry.
Thanks again, Bob. Appreciate that.
You know, and we have the biggest cheerleader in Macomb County standing next to me, Mark Hackle. you always say, make Macomb your home, so it makes it a lot easier to get people in when you have something like this going up.
Yeah, I think Barrymore was here before Macomb was a county. I got to tell you, it's if many of us remember back when it was just two lanes over here, eastbound, westbound, this facility was here. But this guy here is the center of it. You know, you talk about somebody iconic in and around Macomb County that really cares about what's going on. This is the family fun entertainment center of Macomb County, no question about it. It keeps growing. And again, as a kid growing up over the years, you kind of had experiences here, but that experience continues to grow because of the efforts of this guy right here, Rick Iceberg. I know he has got a great team of people behind him making things happen. But as you listen to him talk about what just happened to help build this facility here, this new item that they decided to invest in, he knows everything about it, every aspect of it, because he's intimately involved and he's continuously talking to his team while they're out here making it happen. So again, Rick, we can't thank you enough for continuing to add on this experience out here, not only for the kids, for the adults too. We enjoy having the experience of coming out here, and you keep it a safe, friendly, family fun environment, and I think that's what's most important. So congratulations to you with this new addition to Barrymore's.
Thanks a lot, Mark.
You bet.
I appreciate
thank you.
That much.
Thank you.
Thanks.
You guys have some plaques you want to bring?
Yeah.
We have some plaques to be presented. Phil?
I'm Phil Rowe, District Director for John James, and on behalf of the Congressman, we want to say a few words. We're always very happy for a new business in the area, and for me, it's sort of special because Barrymore's was like the first fun bar in the area in my 20s, so been coming here for a little while. So. And it's provided that entertainment for an extended period of time, and it's unbelievable how you've grown it. So on behalf of the Congressman, we'd like to give you this commendation for a special tribute to Barrymore's. Thank you, Rick.
Thanks, Phil. I appreciate it. Tell John, thank you very much. And tell John I'd like to have him buy me lunch, too.
All right, we'll work on that.
Okay, and Joe Aragona also has a certificate.
Rick, this is awesome. 50 years, it's fantastic. I've been coming here since I was a kid. I know a lot of us have been as well. It's always, you're always adding something new. When I was on the Clinton Township Board, it was great to see, you know, some of the new things that you did. There's a number of state legislators that represent Clinton Township. Veronica Kleinfeld and Kevin Hertel are the state senators. Myself, Alicia St. Germain and Denise Menzer are the state representatives, and we have a bonus state representative on here, your state representative, Jamie Green, who's down there at the end, who came down from Northern Macomb County. We got together, we knew we needed to do something special, so this is an official state tribute from the state of Michigan, and we're very proud that you're here to make Macomb your home, and, sorry, Mark, to make Clinton Township your home. So there you are, sir.
Thanks, Joe. Appreciate that. Thanks, very Joe. Much. That was nice of you guys. And, Jamie, she just can't wait to ride the go-kart.
Okay, and Wayne is Wayne's going to help you cut the ribbon.
Because Wayne built the track, so we would really like Wayne to cut it because he is the guy that made this happen. So I appreciate it very much, Wayne.
Hold it down.
There you go.
Look up, smile, look up, smile. There you go.
All right. He's quick. He was quick.